two young brothers out there that broke into a gun store and stole 22 guns and multiple rounds of ammunition. That's right, comes out of Florida. The boys, they broke into Guns for Less, a firearm store in Cape Coral, about 10 miles outside of Fort Myers, by cutting off power to the business and forcing their way through a back door. And then they smashed display cases and began ransacking the entire business for a total of 22 guns, rifle and handgun magazines, and various calibers of ammunition. And the day before, the brothers had gone there to scout the location. Again, 11 and 14. These are kids. And also, these are pictures here of the location there, the store that they stormed. And what we definitely know about this is that when police arrived on the scene, that the 14-year-old and his 11-year-old brother dropped the weapons, took off in separate directions as they fled from police at around 3 a.m. on June 8th. The older brother kept an AR pistol as he ran, but later tossed it. After the boys fled, officers found both of them near the scene and accounted for all of the stolen items, thankfully. And this isn't the first robbery they've been involved in terms of these youngins. While the older brother is on probation in connection with robbery with a weapon, burglary, and criminal mischief, he has been previously arrested and accused of threatening to harm another juvenile with a weapon on social media. And both brothers were charged with 22 counts of grand theft of a firearm, one count of armed burglary, one count of criminal mischief over $1,000, and one count each of resisting without violence, grand theft, and possession of burglary tools, Green said. And the older brother was also charged with one count of violating his probation. 14 and 11, these are children out there. And yet, they're dying to get their hands on guns, which makes you wonder in terms of what upping the age to 21, whether even if that bill passed the House, would children still try to get their hands on firearms, because it definitely seems to be the case that for some reason they have some drive toward it. And I know that these children didn't necessarily have the best background to begin with, but it does speak to the issue of why we have all of these guns even accessible in stores. Jackson.
Yeah, I mean, well, they likely were robbing the guns so they could sell them on the streets, because, you know, guns make a lot of money on the streets. And, you know, that guns are immediately a part of gang culture, or just being on the streets in any type of way where you don't really have like parental protection. You know, a lot of these kids are going to find their hands on guns rather quickly, and they're going to find out that people need them in the streets and they can sell them. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I think that one of the other hurdles that we have, in addition to passing, you know, real legislation that can minimize the access to guns, is that it's already such a deep part of our culture, you know, and so it's literally going to not just take policy change, but also a lot of time to see the effects. You know, it's not just going to be 1 year later, because even if we make a policy change, you know, the right wing is going to be like, oh, see, there's still gun deaths. You know what I mean? So it's going to be a long fight that we're going to have to change our culture as well.
Absolutely, we are, because the fact is, even just raising the age at all, I don't think that's going to do a damn thing. It's like raising the age for alcohol. You know, people who are minors still get their hands on it. But unfortunately, it's when we're talking guns, like, this is something that's deadly. It's inherently deadly. Guns, that's what they serve the purpose of. Using deadly force and being deadly force by their very existence. So having a society that allows them to be sold so readily, and in the variety of which they do, it's such lethal, these war machines that are accessible to members of the general public. Even if you raise the age to 21, it's a problem that they're still out there and still available and accessible to people.